God, you'd think that these are hard runs with the way that this is going. I'm gonna be really honest. Going between Shantae, which is immensely fast-paced, and this is kind of tough. No reset. Alright, no reset for real this time. No matter what. Oh, I got lucky there. I mean, yeah, rate of sales is a good metric in general, but it's tough to, oh no, I got a different pattern this time. I don't know what's going to happen. Yeah, it's tough to say that the Switch is anything other than the quickest selling, like, debut to market console. I would be really uncomfortable making anything beyond that, representing anything beyond that as anything other than speculation. And I love my Switch. The Switch is an amazing device. Such a habit. Why? Why would you give me a heart? Gone in the door. Let's not beef it this time. Oh no, that crab was on purpose. Since this is no major glitches... Yes, please. Since this is no major glitches, there's no saving quit, so... So we death warp there. I wish that there were more spots where death warp is useful, but when you death warp, you lose all your spells, and spells are more valuable later on. That was good. Thank you. That's really good. Oh, good thing I got that potion. Me? A little bit salty about that, yeah. This is a spooky run. Yeah, this is... The run is getting to the point where we're optimizing it down to skipping hearts. I only pick up the fish heart at this point. That makes the first part of the run super scary. And then a later part of the run is also immensely scary because of it. That was good. That's what I wanted to have happen. So right now it's a lot of one-hit kills. And then we'll get the Shogun Shield and the Dragon Scale Armor, and we'll get a little bit more mellow for a little bit. But we'll stay with the Dragon Skin Armor for a pretty good while. Rude. Rude is what that was. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we really want a boomerang to drop here. Skeletons are the most likely to drop a boomerang. They also drop sacks of cash. Boomerang is pretty rough. So, these skeletons can jump, and it's really scary when they do. If you have a boomerang, then you're just taken care of. Oh. Anything green in this area can one-hit KO you. So, there's those dudes. But the scarier thing is coming up with the genies. Yeah, the mouse morph is super fun to play. That was bad. Well, one hit game over now. And this room is where it's gonna happen. Time to do the cool strat, which is too bad. It's just a little bit too slow. There's a slightly faster strat that you can do there. This room is also pretty scary. Dudes can drop potions if they wanna. They didn't. Alright. Well, I'm gonna buy a couple shame potions after this fight. So there's a apparently very common issue with the Switch Pro controllers where if you're like me and you like to use the D-pad for platformers, left and right inputs on the D-pad tend to also cause up inputs. Turns out that's really bad when up goes indoors. This room either goes super well or super poorly. That time it went super poorly. Good job, game. You figured out how to make me turn around. I haven't played Wonder Boy and Monster World yet, so alright. We're doing okay. Thank you. Okay, we're in really good shape. Supposed to have tornado selected. So these blue dudes are really dangerous. I need the money. Pick up the money. This no morphing. Gain gear with various effects that give you the morph critter's abilities. Okay, that's neat. Yeah, that sounds like a really cool idea. So this is where the route gets really, really scary, because we've still got that dragon scale armor on, which is about as effective as tissue paper, other than the fact that you can fall in the lava without getting hurt. I wanted money. I wish to file a complaint. I love the fact that we're losing time. And yet I haven't been using potions. Just leave that behind. Leave that one behind too. Yeah, right now I'm getting tons of potion pops. I don't know what's up with it. Maybe I'll get the armor drop. That would be really awesome. Would have been nicer. This room can be a little bit scary. Pick up just a tiny bit of money. I lied. No money. Yo, Piantissimo, how's it going? Yeah, I screwed up real bad there. Buy one potion, I think. Buy two. Oh, we're in business. Nice! That's what I wanted. This is good. Scary room. Yeah. bad. It's too high up. It's okay then. We can still make this happen. I think we got it. Oh, barely. Barely. New world record. Well, that's not the worst thing ever. Yo, thanks for the GG. So if watching me be bad at any of these video games seemed fun, I'm going to be doing, obviously, a lot of marathon prep, but in addition, there's Speedrun to Change the World, which is taking place in June. I can give you an actual date in one moment. June 2nd through 4th, raising money for charity water. You should come, you should watch, you should donate lots of money. One of the donation incentives potentially is going to be making me run hard mode on this game, which you do half damage, enemies deal double damage, and there are extra enemies of the yellow variety, which are even harder than any of the blue enemies to kill and hit harder than the blue enemies, so... It's, I believe, going to end up being one of the donation incentives, so watching me run the least marathon-safe version of this game in a marathon should be fun. That looks good, Smurfton. I like that. Yo, Panda Reverb, thank you very much. I've been working at doing marginally less terribly at this game, and obviously, looking at my splits, I've got plenty of work to do. Some of best 35.08, and we still have a trash 36 world record. This needs to be fixed, is all I'm saying. That the bird split was painful, the lion split was really bad. I took the shame potions, which costs like between 5 and 10 seconds. Yeah, the antlions really, really hurt this time. But hey, it's been almost a week since I've PB'd in any category in this game, so this is pretty good. Find somebody to host.